I now know that creation started in Ethiopia, see? Or what you call Africa. And that God is known as Jah. And Jesus was a true-born African. And the first coming of Jah in the physical of man. Marcus Messiah Garvey, one of I-nity prophet, tell me say,
look to Africa, where a black king will be crowned, for the day of deliverance is near.
So black man has been led astray now within this time in thinking of this Jesus Christ concept and the westernized philosophy. But Rastafari come within this time to save I-nity from all those misconcepts, to let I-nity know, say, well, I-nity was here from the beginning of creation and living up to his laws and his statutes that him laid down from that time.
Haile Selassie, he my king, he my God in physical of man. The heartbeat, the first son of creation, Nile Bingi, death to the white and black oppressors. Rastafari, give thanks and praise to Jah. Rastafari.
Rastafari is not a religion, it's a way of life. It's a cleansing of oneself, in short, making oneself a better person. It is the truth that each and every one has the concept of right and wrong. The seals, as talked about in Revelation, we believe are the seals that were open, one's eyes or ears or anything that allows one to make a conception of right or wrong. So therefore it is up to each and every individual to better himself within the society that we live in, to make oneself a better person so that you can contribute a positive effort towards the society we live in. Just a simple thing as food for thought. Many people get together on the 25th of December and there's great celebrations. Myself personally and many of my Rastafarian brothers now tend not to celebrate this celebration, as we realize this is a pagan festival and an adaptation to the Christian way of life, that Rastafari is the original concept of this. All I can say in short is that Rastafari live.
Can you explain to everyone what is Rastafari?
Rastafari is the eradication of evil and replacing it with good. Just as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. When Jah Rastafari created the heavens and the earth, established on the face of the earth was the concept of good. Evil did not prevail. Now, Rastafari is that African livity as it was in the beginning. Because when Jah Rastafari, the creator, put forth man on the face of this earth, the African man, was the man that was put forth.
First
out of the African man came all other races. Man was also treading with closeness to Jah in terms of his mentality was strictly of good and evil did not prevail.
Can we just take one of those topics first? There's quite a lot there to cover. What is livity?
Livity is the way of life.
When you say livity is the way of life, what is the way of life?
Well, I can't speak for any and anyone. I can only speak for I and I as Africans. I-nity as Rastafari is promoting the way of life which has been established by the order of how Jah Rastafari had created things for I, the Africans, to trod, hopefully in the sight as he had ordained it.
So therefore, living livity is a way of life. So what does that incur? What is it?
Livity? To strive for perfection, because I was created in the image and likeness of Jah Rastafari. That was perfection. Everything that the eye behold when Jah created is perfect. There's nothing wrong with what Jah created, you see. So if you may observe how ones and ones are living in this day and age, you may notice that they have removed from the creation as to a greater extent, you see. So treading upright is to move forward in that direction as it was in the beginning, so shall it be.
Can you tell us who is Jah?
Jah,
or what is Jah?
Rastafari is the head creator, the creator of the universe. Jah Rastafari is God himself as come forth from the dawn of creation, right? And as trod with I, even until now. I see his imperial majesty as the living eye God, Jah Rastafari, in the physical concept of I, man.
That's Haile Selassie, yes? I thought Haile Selassie was dead.
In 1975, the Babylonian forces spread propaganda, say, his imperial majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, was killed in a coup. Up to this day, there is no such thing as a body that can be shown unto I and I.
Well,
up to this day, there's
body?
No such thing as a funeral or anything. Now, if this was a coup, right, with those degree of propaganda which the Babylon forces then was trying to spread, right, they would have used that to try and finalize for them points, you
Sorry,
see. So that gap is left open. His imperial majesty has made a mystical exile from the face of the earth, which these forces,
right,
evil forces, do not know about.
Wasn't a Rasta, was he? He was a Christian. He said he was a Christian.
No, we're talking about Christianity now. You must penetrate the concept of Christianity being the first religious concept on the dawn of creation. I, the Ethiopian, were the first people to acknowledge and give thanks and praise to a living God, a creator.
But he denied that he was a living God.
I, as Rastafari, as Ethiopians, right? That acknowledgement of a living creator was the original concept of Christianity. The name Christianity has been distorted and has been taken out of Africa, taken to the shores of Europe, distorted, tinkered and tailored to suit every set of people them impose it on, you see, right? And then it has come back into Africa claiming that that is the original Christianity. That doesn't exist. I, Rastafari, the concept of righteousness prevail. That is the true concept of Christianity.
When you say...
Where do we find the good in the world and where do we find the bad? It's the bad in Babylon and the good in Africa.
Well, when I make mention of Babylon, I right now is in Babylonian territories. Anywhere outside Africa is Babylon, you see. I is not saying, therefore, that Babylonian mentalities do not prevail
in
Africa.
Can I ask you?
I is talking about Babylon, the land, the Babylonian, the people. In Africa, you have Africa is Africa, you see.
Everything
but you have
Africa
people with
Babylon.
Babylonian mentalities.
What do you classify as Babylon then? I mean, for me, I don't know. What do you classify as
Any
Babylon?
Any forces representative of evil is
what
Babylon.
What is evil
what is
for
you?
You tell me what is evil.
No, the question.
I represent the concept of good, and I represent
which is
the
a Rasta.
Eradication
Can
of
I ask
evil.
A question?
I represent the concept of Rastafari.
So Rastafari is good. So where does everybody else stand?
Where does everyone else stand? Well, all Jah Rastafari has established things, right? He created different races of people, right? You may observe, as I said initially,
That when Jah Rastafari created man, he created him in his image and his likeness. That is the black man. Today you observe various manifestation of man, right? That symbolize man as removed from the original creation, you see. Man has also removed himself, not only physically, within the duration of time, but also mentally.
So can I become a Rasta?
White men bad?
Which question is being asked?
So can I become a Rasta?
Within each races of people, there are ways in which they can observe the Creator. The Creator has revealed himself unto each people in different ways, right? I, as an African represent the original concept of the creation. I can associate with Jah Rastafari in his fullness. And next race of people can associate with Jah Rastafari in his fullness, but to the level to which Jah say them can deal with
so
them.
So what about me? Say I wanted to become a Rasta, can I?
Rastafari is a way of life for I, the African. I observe the I as an Asian. I don't know if I is correct in that observation. But even within what well. I and I observe of the I, there is a way in which the I can come up to Jah Rastafari, observing how Jah Rastafari revealed himself unto the I as an Asian person and unto the Asian people. It is not necessarily calling that name Jah Rastafari, you see. You may be acknowledging a different name, you see. But that is the level to which the I as a people can come, right? Rastafari promotes the upliftment of one's own culture, to be oneself, to promote one's livity. So if an Asian person, for example, was to trad Rastafari, he would be violating the very things which Rastafari says, which says, be yourself.
What about the Asian Africans? Can I ask you about the Asian Africans?
Yeah. And I know not such things as Asian African, for the same reason I know not such thing as black British and black Chinese or otherwise.
Are you accepted by black Africans? Are you accepted?
Am I accepted? Yeah. And whose criteria are we going by?
No, I'm just asking.
What is an African?
Well, I'd say that.
One who can trace his ancestral origin to the motherland. African means more than just that geographical. That is the land where man came forth, you know. That land is so sacred. That is the land that gave birth to mankind. So can you imagine the ritual, the spiritual aspect of a land that gave birth to mankind? That is what an African is.
Are Rastafari the most pure, the purest Africans?
Rastafari is an African livity.
Is it the purest?
Trodding the eradication of evil and the fulfillment of goodness, right? Rastafari
African
is the ice livity, right?
The truest
to which
Africans.
A one can observe the concept of the Creator.
There
are ones and ones who are trodding that ice livity, which means trodding as natural, right? As the original concept. Right? There are ones and ones even within the land of Africa who may not bear the name Rastafari as I know them, right? But when you analyze that livity, you see that it is Rastafari.
But you said there was different levels of Rastafarian.
There is no different level of Rastafari.
There's only one truth.
Rastafari is a oneness. Rastafari is one.
Well, so what are white Rastas then? What are white Rastas?
There is no such thing as white Rastas. For the same reason, there's no such thing as a spotless leopard or a white Ethiopian or a white Maasai.
Can I ask you something? Sorry, can we go back to... Right, can you tell us, you said it's important about what you eat for your liberty. Can you tell us... Well, exactly what it is you eat or what your diet would be.
Rastafari is the preservation of oneself in its natural and its most spiritual form. Thereby, certain things cannot enter the body that will actually defy the structure, that will actually be sacrilegious to the body, which is a temple of the Most High. I and I therefore full take in food which are ital, right?
What does this mean?
Ital, by ital I mean food that are vital for I and I way of life, for I and I to keep I and I structure hopeful, healthy, and in accordance with the order of our Jah as established things. By that I mean I and I's I Rastafari livity is a trad of abstention from animal products, animal meats, abstention from alcohol, abstention from cigarette, abstention from wines, abstention from dairy product, abstention from all other piracy or exploitation in whatever form of animal and their...
But the Rastafarian takes ganja. Well, what's that? I mean, is that...
Fishes are the glories of the sea. Right? I do not partake in the... I do not partake, right, in the eradication of the fish. Because they are also life form.
Alcohol.
Life must be respected.
What would you say? What was that? Of ganja. The taking of ganja, which is part of, which I think, what I've read, is part of your religion. Is that true?
First and foremost, I say, ganja, right, is not all dread take ganja. You don't, to be Rastafari, you must take ganja, right? Ganja is a sacred herb. Jah has established on the face of this earth, herb-bearing seed, right? And all those must be utilized for the use of man. Now, Babylonian laws try to outlaw ganja for reasons, knowing that they can't exploit it. For reasons, knowing that that is spiritual food for I and I and for those who choose to partake in it, right?
Yeah.
How can man say, right, that what God has established to grow on the face of this earth is illegal?
Well, when you take
the... Right? Opium is a chemically processed things.
What about ganja raw opium poppy? Right?
There are many products on the face of this earth, right? That if used incorrectly, it is detrimental, destructive to the system, to the body.
But
ganja has not proven, has never been proven, has never up to this date been proven to be detrimental to the structure.
Can I ask you which country you were born in?
That is irrelevant.
Why is it irrelevant?
Right? Because irrespective of the country that I and I was born in, right? I and I are sons and daughters of Africa. You are an African daughter, whether you know it or not, whether you choose to accept it or not.
Okay, do you want to live there? Do you want to go back to live in Africa?
Repatriation is essential. Repatriation is a must, because until sons and daughters of Africa forward to Africa, right? Black people all over the world shall always be abused, used, and abused. It is important.
When you get to Africa, what will you do?
Remember, you must first remember, right? I and I were kidnapped from Africa and taken into subhuman bondage to build up this system, right?
Yeah.
Even so, once we build up the system, they did not say, all right, get out of here and go back to Africa. They did not say that.
No.
The reason why is that, right? Because we are still needed here, right? To keep this system running, to keep suppressing us, to keep exploiting the richest continent on the face of the earth.
But I watch the news. I see Ethiopia. In Ethiopia, there's a war. There's a famine and there's a plague of locusts. If you go and live back in Ethiopia, there's going to be a lot of problems. And you're going to need the technology and the science of the 20th century of Babylon if you're going to survive. So how are you going to get around that?
That's how you see problems solved, right? Let me tell you first and foremost, right? You getting your information from what you watch on the news.
Yeah, that's
you getting information what they're feeding you. And when you're in control of the media, you feed what you want to feed out there. Secondly, to even answer your question, I and I contribution as sons and daughters of Africa. First and foremost is that we who still chant Africa today after being out here for 500 years shows that the African spirit has not been suffocated, has not been suppressed, and will not. Now it's for those conscious ones to go forward to Africa and make their contribution by the lessons that I and I have learned, right? We do not see the implementation of modern technology. After all, Babylon has got all the modern technology and it's got more problem than locusts and than starving.
So in what way will you make your contribution?
And than what you made mention
of. That you're a minority and that there are a lot of black people out there looking today who do not have any, well, do not want to go back to Africa. There's blacks in America, blacks in South America, there's blacks all over the world who do not want to go back to Africa. What do you think
First
about
and foremost, when you say Aina is in a minority, I'm not playing about with numbers games. You know, see, Jah forces are always in a minority. It's not who have the most number win, right?
Yeah.
To answer that question more directly now, right? Aina is fully aware that there are people who have no intention of going to Africa,
whether in America or otherwise, who have no intention. And I is also fully aware that Babylon is going to burn. Babylon must fall. And every day as you open your eyes and look, you say, Babylon falling. You see the first blocks them starting to crumble and fall. Who want to burn in Babylon? Let them burn. But Jah, Rastafari, has revealed himself unto all Africans, right? And they know of him. And it's for those who choose to tread righteously, to follow and to pursue that reality. And those who want to deal with fantasy and deal with the coziness and cuddliness of how Western society has sold and packaged themselves.
What is Western society you're talking about?
When Babylon burns, what's going to happen to you?
What is going to happen to I when Babylon burns?
Yeah.
Right? Righteousness lives forever. Right?
So you're going to live forever?
Death is for destructive, for wickeds.
And people
see,
who
right?
consider themselves...
Righteousness live forever. All that I want to interpret it, that is up to the eye.
How can I stop myself from being burnt in Babylon as a white person?
You as a white man, Jah Rastafari has even revealed a way for you unto which you can give thanks and praise and acknowledge the order about things has been established, you see. Your livity is not a livity of Rastafari, but within your livity, there is a way in which you can give thanks and praise and trod upright. That is for you to find. That is not for me to find.
When
I know where I'm going,
when
right?
you, when
and I pursue my realities.
When you go, when the Rastafari go back to Ethiopia, what stance will the women have in that?
First and foremost, Rastafari don't deal with no backward business. We don't go back to Ethiopia otherwise.
Where will the woman stand in that? Where does she stand?
Oh, you mean where does the woman stand?
I mean,
Rastafari is not a male-oriented nothing in us. Rastafari is a oneness, a family union. Rastafari is not something whereby it's just man alone. You know, how can a family exist on man alone?
Well,
what kind of question is that? Is that I incorporating some of this Babylonian feminism thing in that make the eyes asking such a question as to where
tell
does
me where
the woman
stand? Stands in the Rastafari's religion.
King Rastafari, right? On the 2nd of November 1930, the coronation of King Rastafari, where he was crowned Emperor of Ethiopia. I elect of this world and earth's rightful ruler, and 72 nations bow down and acknowledge that, right? That coronation was also a marriage, right? Because that was a marriage with him and Queen Omega, you see, right? That is one example.
It's a marriage. Is imperial
Majesty Trad, right? Is an example for Aina as Rastafari. That significant move shows her, yes, this is a balancing up, right? We don't deal with an unbalanced thing whereby it's just a man alone, you know, where it's just man alone, you know, see, right? So does that answer that initial question, right? About female. Now dealing with marriage. You say Rastafari don't deal with marriage, right?
I
as Africans, right, has been kidnapped and taken outside in Babylon, first and foremost, right? The systems of marriages which I and I have in Africa, right? Seen? We don't even know which part of Africa we come forward from. So we don't know which system we even deal with, right? That is not to say that Rastafari don't deal with marriage. Whether we go down with our queen and bow before Jah and pray to Jah and make Jah seal up that union, that is marriage. Or whether we take on an African traditional ceremony, that is marriage. But what I'm saying to you, marriage is a vow between the Almighty Eye, whether it is done directly with Jah and the presence of your wife, or whether it is done through a priest.
On the South African issue, yeah, as a Rasta, what are your feelings towards Steve Biko, who actually fought for a black South Africa, and also his views on Africa was that Africa should be a black man's land. His views were similar of that to a Rasta, even though Steve Biko was not a Rasta.
Yeah, there are many African heroes who have shed their blood in the liberation of I-nity African soils, you see. In this dispensation, in this time, many of those spirits have come forward in the physical manifestation as we know them today. I, Rastafari, you see.
Mm-hmm. There's a word that's in the Rastafari vocabulary, which is Nyambingi. What is that?
Nyambingi is the undiluted concept of the livity of Rastafari. The utterance Nyambingi chants death to white downpressers and their black counterparts.
I thought you were against violence. You say death. Does that mean you're going to kill them?
Right now,
in the order of all I-nity livity is, right? I-nity must know to balance certain things in the eradication of evil, right? Yeah. It would be stupid of I-nity if I-nity to say I-nity is going to turn the other cheek if I-nity is being abused, because His Imperial Majesty himself picked up arms and fought against Mussolini and the Italian invasion, right? There is times, right, when I-nity must know. You see, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding is the trinity that is essential, right? If you have wisdom, right, knowledge and understanding, it would be rather stupid.
What is understanding?
You would class it as understanding, right? We don't deal with hand.
Okay.
You know, see, right? It would be rather stupid if somebody box you, right, and joke in your eyes, you know, see, and you turn around and say, forgive him.
I think you I hear you say though earlier, right, that you are a man of peace.
Rastafari.
And I hear you talking about war, I hear you talking about violence an awful lot. And I don't get the feeling of peace from you. You're shouting a lot. Yes?
Right. I am a lion. First and foremost, aggressive. I represent a lion of Rastafari.
Yeah.
See? A lion is not a pussycat. Right? No. Even the manner in which the item is trodden right now. See? If I-nity was a pussycat, I'd go down, right? You say I-nity is shouting, simply because you can't intimidate me in certain manner.
I'm not trying to intimidate you.
That is the line.
There's a certain point
when
you say
that. What does the line actually signify? Because in a lot of Rasta Ivory's books, dresswear, you always see the lion. What does it actually signify?
Well, in Africa, there are various totems, you see. The lion is representative of Ethiopian. See, the Lion of Judah, that is Jah Rastafari.